Scientists have yet to invent a time machine, so there's no way to see what life was for a peasant in the Dark Ages firsthand. However, playing ranked on King's Canon is a pretty close comparison. You might think, the cage seems like a nice landing spot. It has decent loot and good rotations, right? Wrong. Every time you choose to land there, you're actively deciding to get railed by more people than the brunette on the front page of your favorite adult entertainment website. New players might be surprised to discover there are no batteries on the entire King's Canyon. The reason is that shield batteries were only invented in Season 3 by Crypto, and they were first introduced on World's Edge. You can at least craft them, you know, that's something. Getting respawned anywhere on King's Canyon is like visiting a strip club in your 50s. Your expectations are quite low, and still, you will be disappointed. King's Canyon isn't all bad. There are some pretty toxic people out there that enjoy playing caustic, like me, and for them I have only one thing to say: welcome home, baby. Personally, I'm a big fan of dropping on containment. I get the adrenaline rush of defeating 3 different squads and getting some pretty decent loot. The second you win the fight, the longbow squad sitting on the north and the south will helpfully send you to the lobby so you can experience the fun all over again. If you still miss Kotown, check out Crash Site. There's always at least 3 Predator squads dropping there, and the loot is actually good. I'm not sure if it's the map or just the player base evolving, however each final circle is played by all squads as if their families are held at gunpoint, and winning the match is the only way they live. Expect plenty of camping and sniping. When it comes to jump towers, I have only one tip: don't use them. If you however have to, just use them to jump off the map so the suffering ends quickly. There isn't a single case in the history of the entire game of someone using a jump tower on King's Canyon and surviving the ensuing 3rd, 4th and 5th party. There is only one spot for a player who doesn't find a gun instantly the second they drop on King's Canyon, and that of course is the lobby. New players might think the name of the map is derived after some geographic feature. Veterans, however, know the truth. It's named after the shape of your asshole after you play too much ranked on the map. There are very few backpacks to find on King's Canyon. This is helpfully fixed by an overall lack of loot on the map. While there are no good spots to drop on King's Canyon, do keep in mind that large sections of the map are meant entirely for sightseeing and rotations. Dropping in an area without a name means you have to play rock, paper, scissors with your squad. The winner gets a P2020 you found, the loser gets some sniper attachments and maybe a grenade. Good luck winning. If you find yourself missing the fist fighting of the ring on Olympus, just drop at the town between airbase and bunker. While there is no containment area to preserve you from getting shot, there are also no weapon spawns there, so you can fist fight to your heart's content.